all know today, the Prime Minister has announced that the farm laws will be repealed. This is a historic victory for the farmers' movement led by the Samyukta Kisan Morcha. As you know, this struggle has been going on for nearly 1 year. November 26th, this month, would have marked the completion of 1 year of the struggle. And the struggle has been conducted by all the Kisan organizations unitedly, and they have shown great courage and fortitude in facing all odds, state police repression, and all other were found to try to disrupt the movement, but the farmers have conducted the struggle victoriously. This is going to be a landmark in the history of independent India. The coming parliament session will have to formally repeal these three legislations or laws. But at the same time, it is important that the government pass a law guaranteeing minimum support price for all crops. This should be a legal guarantee, a backing. This is what the farmers would like. At the same time, we would also like the government to reconsider the electricity bill, because that is also a law which the farmers have opposed, which is planning to privatize all the distribution of electricity. So while congratulating the farmers on this victory, we hope that the unity of this farmers movement will continue, so that vital issues concerning the interests of the farmers of this country will continue to be taken up. Second question is also connected with farmers. The central government has decided not to undertake paddy procurement of paddy from several states, on the plea that there is sufficient stocks of paddy with the Food Corporation of India. This is going to put farmers in great difficulty, because if there is no procurement on minimum support price for paddy, there will be distressed sales and farmers are going to suffer. Already the demand has been raised by various state governments. Yesterday the Telangana Chief Minister sat on a dharna on this issue, demanding that centre procure paddy. So we are also, our party also has demanded that paddy procurement must be undertaken by the central government. It should not shirk its responsibility in this matter. The other issue concerns the petrol and diesel prices. The government announced a reduction in the excise duty, central excise duty, of rupees 5 for petrol and rupees 10 for diesel per litre. But this is only a token reduction. Actually, the Modi government has increased taxes on petrol and diesel to such an extent that even now 31 rupees per litre for petrol and 33 rupees per litre for diesel is levied by additional excise duties and special cesses. Then there is a cess on agriculture, cess on roadways. All this is added on to the price of petroleum products. And that is why the central government now, after reducing rupees 5 and rupees 10, they are saying now the state government should reduce their taxes like VAT on petrol and diesel. But this is totally unfair, because the bulk of the taxes today levied by the central government in the form of special taxes and cesses, they are not divided with the states. It is non-divisible. Excise duty, what they levy is shared by the center and the state governments. But that is only 1.40 rupees per liter, which is shared. This 31 and 33 rupees which I talked about, that is not shared with the states. So they are not giving states a share through using this mechanism of special additional excise duties or cesses. On the other hand, they are asking the state governments to reduce the VAT or taxes levied by the state government. Currently, many of the state governments, the non-BJP state governments, have said we cannot reduce taxes. We have not increased it. You have kept on increasing the central taxes. So you will find very soon that this reduction in of 5 rupees and 10 rupees will not matter, and again prices of petrol and diesel will start increasing. They have done this only for the elections which are going to come in Uttar Pradesh, Punjab, Uttarakhand, etc. And afterwards you will find again the rate of petrol and diesel prices will increase, because so much tax burden is there imposed by the central government. So our demand is that the government should do away with these cesses and special taxes, which are outside the framework of the constitution, where all the taxes are to be shared by the center and the states. On one hand, you are depriving states of their revenue. On the other hand, you are going on keeping more burden on the people through these increased taxes. This is very important, because the BJP central government has asked its state governments to reduce their taxes in the name of taxes are mainly to be reduced by the state government. But the main culprit is the central government, and the taxes which they have still levying on petrol and diesel, huge amount. As I said, 31 rupees and 33 rupees, that should be substantially cut. Only then real relief will be there for the petrol consumers or diesel consumers. The other thing which is happening, our party Polit Bureau met last week.